Iveco Daily brake problems. Since my 2 weeks trip to the North Cape in Norway this summer, it was really time to fix the brakes on my Iveco Daily. I also had a warning light on my dashboard. The front brake discs looked okay, but not the rear ones. I changed the brake pads both front and back. Still, the brakes were not good enough. Most likely, I had also introduced some air into the system, making the brake pedal feel all spongy. My Iveco 2006 35S17V has the Brembo dual 42mm piston calipers in the front and the Brembo single 52mm calipers on the rear axle, combined with the parking brake lever. I found out that the glide pins were stuck. Most likely this was the reason that the disc looked like this. I was able to, with a lot of work, get the glide pins loose, lubricate and change the rubber parts. But still, I was pretty sure that the problem will continue. I decided to let the garage fix the front brake calipers and pads. In any case, you really need to have good brakes. They also found out that the earthing part of the lid of the brake fluid container were faulty, and that was the reason of my warning light on the dashboard. Now for the rear brakes. Having changed the pads didn't help. The discs will never be good. You just can't expect the rust to be polished off by the pads. They are of a softer material. I decided to overhaul the calipers instead. I bought a kit with new glide pins, screws, rubber parts, seals and a piston. I removed the caliper and the seat, but was not able to get the hose off. So sitting on the ground working on this was not the best position, but had to go for now. I was able to get the piston out and saw this inside. A screw, a nut-like thing and some loose parts. Not too good. By looking at the instructions on this website, I understood that you have to take this part out as well. Getting the piston, the washers and everything back together was not that easy. You also have to loosen this pin or screw to be able to get the bottom part to fit again. After many hours of work on a parking lot near a local car parts shop, I had to give up. I was unable to get the pin out. I had to clamp the hose to not leak brake fluid and then put everything together again, just to get back home in order to order a completely new caliper and seat instead. To see more videos about travel and photography, you should comment, like and subscribe, and I'll see you soon again. Bye bye.